Everyone, welcome back. Previous video, we created shots 5 and 6. So we should have something kind of like this. Let me turn my grid lines off. Forgot to add those on. We should have something like this for shot 5, which looks pretty cool. For shot 6, we should have something like this, which we're going to put into slow motion. A couple things I noticed between videos. I forgot to change the sensor height and width. So we have one at 20 by 12. And one at 16 by 9. Yours might be 16 by 9 DSLR, I think, which is the default option. But we want that to be 20 by 12 as well. Also, we need to bring our character into focus. So we're going to fix that and then continue on with shot 7 and 8. And our sequence should be done at that point, but we're going to add some additional polish, such as effects, music, and the slowdown that we talked about. So we're going to add that as well. Let's go ahead and continue. Let's go into shot 06. Shot 06 here. And let's see, it starts about there. Let's change the camera settings here. Let's change this to 20 by 12, like so. Hit Control S to save that. I don't know if that actually saved. Let's do it again. There we go. And let's go ahead, let's just double check, make sure it saved it that time. Yeah. All right, inside shot 06. Let's add the focus settings for so that we're focused on this character here. So I'm going to go to the camera, going to go to the focus settings, click the eyedropper, select our grunt, should bring him into focus. Going to add a keyframe for that, and make sure it added it, which it looks like it does. So that's going to be our shot now, a little bit better. A little bit of a pop there as it's shifting between animations, which we'll fix. In a moment. Actually, let's try and fix that right now. Not quite sure why it's doing that. Should be inside of this. Is it this here? Yeah, it's still that. It's still kind of popping when you play it at full speed. Let's zoom in. Let's take the grid snapping off. Move these over just a little bit more. We don't want them right on top of each other. That's as far as I can move them in, huh? Let's zoom out a little bit. I can also change the interpolation type here. Let's just see if that helps. Let's right click. Let's say constant for both of these. Zoom out to this level here. Let's turn this back on. It's still kind of popping there. We might hide that with a camera cut. In fact, we are going to cut. This is showing you all the tools here, all the tricks to getting around things like this. We'll probably cut before that happens, actually. So before it gets to that little pop. I thought that would fix it 100%, but it doesn't look like it did. So we're going to cut before that happens to a different angle anyway. So let's see. Let's go ahead and let's finish shot 7 and shot 8. So we'll take shot 6 here, we'll right-click, let's duplicate that, and we'll call that shot 07. Then we'll put it right on top, and let's find a good place to cut. Probably 683 it looks like, somewhere around there. For the top one, we'll do control comma. And for the bottom one, control period. And let's see how we can fix this now. So if we play, he's going to go into that. I wonder if we could, let's take shot 7 and just push it in one frame. See if that helps. No. Push it in one frame and then let's delete that frame. So I'm going to do a control comma here just to cut out that frame that's giving us the issue. Let's see if that works. Yeah, it looks like that. What I did, I just cut out that frame. I still see the furnace kind of pop a little bit, but that's negligible at this point. And we're going to be cutting cameras anyway in shot 7 right here. So let's go into shot 7. Open that up. Take the camera cuts. Take the camera cuts here. Take this camera. Delete both of those. And let's add a camera now. Add a camera. Let's go ahead and change the sensor width before we forget. Let's control S to save that. And let's pilot our camera now. Find out the shot that we want. For this particular shot, for shot 7, we'll do something like this. Move this over. So do something like this from this angle, because the character is going to crouch down, fire a cannon, shooting our bear. So this looks like a good angle to do that. So let's add a transform for this somewhere around here. Hit S. He's going to go into his stance and fire the cannon, which kills our bear. And at this point, we're going to want to have the camera follow the bear all the way down into its final resting position. So I'm going to move this over just a little bit. Oops. Let's just make sure that we're at the end of the animation. I'm going to hit S, see what that looks like. Looks pretty cool. Except we're going to want to stay on this portion a little bit longer, and then when he gets the shot, follow the bear. So for that, what we'll do, let's I'm going to move the camera back to about there. Hit S. Just a little bit slower movement here. And then it continues on. Probably need to do that a little bit more, actually. Let's delete this keyframe. And let's go all the way to the shot. Which is hard to see in that viewport. Because we're already moving. So we'll go about right there. I'm going to move the camera back, actually. I'm going to hit S. So we get a little bit of back and forth movement, which is fine. And then when we get to here, the shot happens. Camera picks up speed and follows the bear. Let's see how much movement that is. I'm going to hit spacebar and play that. I think that's fine. I think that's good. We're not doing anything for professional use here. We're just having fun, right? So I think that's good. That's going to be the shot for shot 7. Shot 8 is going to be a front shot, almost like this, kind of panning back over the top of the bear. So let's go ahead and do that, and then we'll close out this video. Let's see what it looks like on the master here. Looks good. Looks good. And then at this point, we're going to be duplicating shot 7. So I'm going to duplicate shot 7. Call it shot 8. This is going to be the last shot in our scene. Take that down, put it underneath. Go ahead and let's do a control comma on this one and a control period on that one. So now we get that. And if we go into shot 08, take our camera cuts, take our camera, delete both of those. Add a camera now. It should be pros at this by now. Let's go ahead and change the sensor width. 12, control S to save that. Now we're ready to frame up the shot. Once we pilot again. And for this, what we'll do is kind of pull back. Something like this is what I'm thinking, out the door. So that's going to be really cool. So I'm going to do something, kind of frame it up like this, so that all I have to do is press W, kind of maybe pitch the camera to go forward, S to go back, right out the back like that. Maybe even going right through that would be cool. So that looks good. So I'm holding the right mouse button and trying to find the right spot. Yeah, something like that. So all I have to do is press S to go backwards from the shot. So I'm going to add a keyframe somewhere around here. I'm going to hit S. And Let's go back up to the master level real quick. I want to see where that's taking over. Yeah, right when he gets up. Yep, looks good. Let's go ahead and focus on our character before we forget. Focus on our character, add a keyframe. And now what we should see is him getting up and idling. And at this point, we could go all the way to the end of our subscene here. And let's pilot our camera. Right mouse button, just press S to go back through the gate, something like that. And we're going to fade in and fade out as well, so it doesn't have to be quite perfect. So the camera selected, and press S. Looks pretty cool. So it'll look something like that. And then we'll fade out. So from the master level now, we should have all of our shots, actually. Let's see, let's make sure that our sensor widths are the same. Yep. And actually, our shot needs to be a little bit longer to incorporate the whole thing. Stretch this out a little bit more, 950, let's see. Looks like 934-ish. We're going to be fading out way before here anyway. All right. That is going to do it for this video. We are going to pause in the next video. We're going to do our final polish. We're going to add our sound. We're going to do our slow-mo. We're going to add our effects. And then we may do one more bonus video where we talk about creating alternate takes for our cinematic, as well as the master sequence. And if we have time, we'll talk about these two guys here. I'll just show you how you can use those because they're pretty easy. That's going to do it for this video. Thank you guys for watching. We'll see you in the next video.